Bicyclist, a defender of liberty, a man of peace, a champion of the Constitution, Congressman and Doctor Ron Paul.
Free education, free medical care. Well, you're not entitled to it, but somebody has to take it from somebody else. And the other thing that happens is the entitlement system is put crumbs to the poor and taken, and the rich get richer. And the housing bubble is a perfect example. First, the Fed creates a lot of credit and says, we're going to make the credit available for Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, and everybody's going to get a house. Oh, there's some people who don't qualify. They will lower the qualifications and will force you to make these loans. And then there are the mortgage companies and the building companies and the bankers, and they get involved and they see all this credit flushing around. They get involved in the derivatives market and they make billions and billions of dollars. It's very obvious a bubble is there. And they say, oh yeah, but look at what we're doing for the poor people. They all have houses. The price of the houses are going up and they keep borrowing against their equity. This is the golden age of permanent prosperity, yeah, until the obvious bubble bursts. Yeah. And then what happens? Who comes crawling to the government? The people who've been making all the money. And then they get the bailout, and the middle class loses their jobs and they lose their house. The entitlement system doesn't work. What we need is to have honesty with government, honesty with money, and honesty with allowing people to keep the peace of their life. One thing about the whole concept of liberty and how freedom brings us together, I have said, and I absolutely believe it, I think freedom is popular. And it is, once you understand this, it should bring us all together. No matter how we want to use our freedom. There's been too many in the nanny state business who says that, well, we can't trust everybody to spend their money the way they want. They might not do a good job. And we can't certainly allow you to practice personal social habits because you might do things, you might smoke or drink something you don't want you to. So we have to guide you to make you better people and make it a better economy. But if you understand liberty, if you understand that you have the right to your life and the fruits of your labor, this should bring us all together as long as we're not judgmental. Because if you legalize something, if you legalize personal behavior or religious beliefs or intellectual pursuits, that doesn't mean we for a minute endorse what people do. We should recognize this as religious behavior. People can have different religious beliefs. We don't put people in jail for that. And also if people have no religious belief. So we sort of bring people together this way. But as soon as it comes to personal habits, as soon as it comes to spending your money, then we have these do-gooders that are on both sides of the aisle. They're due back and forth. And the job that we have as promoters in this freedom movement is to bring people together, bring diverse people together and say, it's in all our interest to defend liberty, and you get to decide how you want to use your liberty any way you want.
Thank you.
occupation or using your liberty, you can do things that might harm yourself, but you can't do things that will harm your neighbor. And that's a big difference. But when it is assumed that the government is there to protect you against yourself and against your own decision, that's when there's nothing left. And we're in that category right now. The government is so involved in everything that we do. That's why you have DEA agents coming and arresting people and throwing them in prison and forgetting about it. But that's just one episode. This is happening all the time. This whole notion that these drug laws have to be enforced regardless. We have a couple hundred of these operations, these sting operations, these break-ins and striking, 200 a day. You can rest assured that it's not with proper search warrants and proper conditions. But the whole idea that they're going to make things better, it is the problem. It is that violation that comes, and the founders were pretty astute on blockers. They didn't want a national police force. Yet even before 9/11, over 100,000 U.S. bureaucrats carried guns. The bureaucrats had to carry guns to enforce all these laws. Wow. So I think our problem is that we just have too many laws. We have 5% of the population and 25% of the prisoners. So I would say, American people aren't any worse than the other country. I think we just have too many laws, and it's the repeal of laws that we have to get.
Yeah.